大変な反響ぶりだったんじゃないかと思うんですけれども、2日とも見事ソールドアウト、2回もパンパンという状態でですね、行ってまいりました。そしてメンバーのですね、レアなインタビューを撮ってまいりましたので、早速ライブと合わせてご覧ください。
はい、MTV ロックス、今ここは渋谷のオンエアウエストの楽屋に来てるんですけども、これから、ライブを行うリンプビズキットの、メンバーを捕まえてインタビューをしたいと思います。日本初登場ということで、まあ、DJ リーサルだけはね、日本に前にも来たことあると思うんですけど、 Thanks for taking your time today. Nice to meet you. And I think you guys, it's your first time in Japan, right?
Yeah, but
it's not your first time.
One other time I was here.
Yeah,
which is
2 years ago.
2 and a half.
Uh-huh. Yeah. So how do you like Japan so far?
Love it.
Yeah, basic question.
Best experience we've ever had.
Yeah. Do you like the food? I mean, did you get any time to walk around? See what it's like?
Yeah. We've done a lot of walking. We've walked too much.
Yeah. Like, what kind of places you go?
Arcade.
Every arcade.
Everywhere.
Uh-huh. How many nights are you spending in Japan altogether?
8 days. Eight.
Yeah. That's enough time to walk around a little bit.
Yeah.
And then you're originally from Florida, Jacksonville, mm-hmm. this town, yeah?
Yeah.
And I understand that
Seth Lee is from LA.
Except for Lee.
Oh yeah.
I'm the only exception.
I didn't count him in. So first, the guys from Korn listened to your demo tapes and brought it back to their producers, and so that's how it all happened, right?
That's how it started getting going, kind of, pretty much.
You know, we got our own record deal, but they loved us a lot.
Yeah, they took us out on tour before we even had a record deal.
All right.
You know, and we did it like two or three, we've done three tours with Korn throughout the States, and it just went from Korn to the Warped Tour to Faith No More to Primus to the Deftones to Japan and back to headline in the States after this.
All right, yeah. So I was just really impressed, like you guys rehearsed really hard. Yeah, I thought you guys were never going to stop sound checking. Yeah, so never going to give me any time to interview you guys.
It's our only time to practice.
We try to utilize the time to write a lot instead of just going over old material. Yeah. We try to get as much writing and, mm-hmm. you know, jam out and everything.
Oh.
Psycho female blowing up my phone line. I need to tighten that screw, it's been loose for a long time. Jam, I was glad with some bad luck. Soon I'm gonna rip you through with a buck, buck. And now you talk shop, go to bad loose with the 30 up. Fast with a drip of our destiny. Shout to my body, what did you bring back?
yo!
White trash. In Japan.
Okay, so we could go to some basic questions. Like, how did you guys all first meet up? Like, back in '94, you guys got together?
That's a little too complicated.
Yeah. Too complicated?
Yeah, more basic.
Please.
Oh, go ahead.
We were all in other bands. Uh-huh. And I was trying to mix a lot of styles. Hip-hop, mm-hmm. heavy, alternative.
Yeah.
A lot of things. And couldn't find the people to do it right, so sort of went around to different bands and took a member from each band.
Mm-hmm.
Found Sam, the bass player, first, and then mm-hmm. his cousin is John, the drummer, who's in another band, and Wes was in another band, and Lethal was in House of Pain.
Mm-hmm.
So we all just sort of left our old bands behind and mm-hmm. formed a new one, you know, right. called Limp Bizkit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, so how do you write the songs when does somebody come up with like basic track or something?
Oh, it's what we feel. Yeah.
So is it usually like all you guys all put it together? Like
everybody
jamming together. It's pretty spontaneous. Just jamming in the rehearsal, mm-hmm. Or whatever. Just sound checks sometimes. Uh-huh. Sometimes whatever.
We were playing some new stuff today.
Mm-hmm.
You know, a couple new songs today that we made up. We were playing.
So I got kind of scared because like you guys looked like you were arguing on stage there. And these guys are really serious about the music
Let me let you punks know I'm an old school soul.
So get out your seat and jump around, jump around. or better yet, a Terminator. Like Arnold Schwarzenegger, trying to play me out like as if my name was Sega. But I ain't going out like no perk, bitch. Get used to one style, yo, when I might switch it up, up and around. Then buck, buck, get down, put out your head, and then you wake up in the dawn of the dead. I'm coming to get ya, I'm coming to get ya. Spitting out lyrics, homie, I want ya. I came to get down, I came to get down. So get out your seat and jump around. Jump around. Jump around. Jump around. Jump up and get down.
So far, are you ready for another album?
Like something? Three songs. Like, we're not ready. We wait till we're writing on the road. Uh-huh. But it's kind of spontaneous when it's time to write a new record. However we're feeling, yeah. we'll start writing it. Just whatever, you know. Everybody writes their own parts, and mm-hmm. we all get involved with each other's parts and compose, and it just happens on the spot. Whatever we're feeling, angry, frustrated, fear, whatever we're feeling, it sort of drives the song, you know. So we don't anticipate anything. We only have three new songs so far, but they're really cool. We've got a couple covers, like The Faith that we did by George Michael's, that we're trying to pick one to beat that one. That's hard. That's a good one.
Who picked that one? Was that your idea?
Yeah.
That was a good track. Yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty funny.
So what kind of music are in, like, your backgrounds? Like, what kind of music do you listen to? Because I heard you, like, playing Master of Puppets or...
I used to Jimi
Hendrix.
I like, used to get into a lot of really, like, metal, rock guitar stuff when I was, like, 14 years old when I started playing guitar. So I would buy the Metallica book and, learn all the songs and stuff. And, actually, it's kind of embarrassing to say Metallica has helped me in riff-wise a lot, but I'm glad that I've moved on to some more tasteful music since then.
Well, it's good to practice on,
They're killer.
I grew up with Metallica and all that. I studied a lot of jazz. And I'm into a lot of hip-hop, especially right now, but that's pretty much everything for me. I listen to all different kinds of music.
Yeah, it's kind of hard to ask you.
I got too many records. Frank Sinatra.
Okay, Tony Bennett.
Yeah.
I was into metal and grunge.
Metal and grunge?
Seattle scene.
Uh-huh. Yeah, and Matt?
I like everything. I like everything, you know, from... You know, starting back out with like 80s glam, disco, pop music to, old school hip hop.
Yeah.
Back in the 80s, Rakim, Eric B. and Rakim, and I like Cypress Hill, I like Korn, I like Deftones. I'm influenced by like Zeppelin, Tool. Everybody influences me. Everything I like influences me. I like so much music, and if I like it, it will influence me and my writing, no matter what it is.
Kill the pollution! Pollution!
Yeah. the mouth. Jump out to the skyline, keep them on the sideline, choking on my fly rhymes. Need to hide a maneuver, you ain't no joke, you're gonna choke when I'm playing it to ya.
Business for the band, but I don't think we have a leader. I think we're all just Limp, Bizkit, and all
right, yeah,
you know, and mm-hmm. everyone else is kind of involved in their mm-hmm. they I think they like that they don't have to deal with the business.
Yeah. Well, I think it's like this singer's vibe, kind of like putting all kinds of music together, like different kinds of music.
Yeah, we do, like when everyone's writing their parts, I do yeah. try whether I want to or not, take overbearing approach in composing the songs,
mm-hmm.
but we all work good that way. We mm-hmm. all, you know, or we have a chemistry that we're just real lucky to have found. The chemistry that we have, I mean, it's really fortunate to be a successful crossover mm-hmm. band.
Oh yeah,
you know, mixing all styles and pulling it off. I mean, a lot of bands, just if they're mixing hip hop and heavy, then they sound like a metal rap band or a funk. Something they can't like do it all.
Yeah.
And it seems like we were kind of pulling off a little bit of everything.
Mm-hmm.
And we have songs that don't even sound like you heard us in soundcheck today,
right.
Like singing songs that are like totally different than.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we can go any way.
Any direction. Every direction we can go in. We could do straight hip-hop music that would sound just like what's going on in hip-hop today. We could do straight alternative that could be on alternative radio all day long and on TV all day. We could do heavy, heavy music that could be the heaviest of the heavy, but we don't like to stay in one direction. We always want to mix it up, you know?
Everybody's slave, I'm making my slave.
2 seconds. Yeah. Like Wes said something, I said something, and that was it. Yeah. And then I went to Sugar Ray or something. But this is the first time we've ever, like, we don't know what to say. Usually it's pretty easy.
Well, talking about Sugar Ray, DJ Lethal, like, talking about a band, right?
The first
mm-hmm.
album, yeah.
It was
a good one.
Well, okay, let's change some subjects. So basically, four of you are from Florida. So, how's the club scene like?
There is no scene.
No scene.
The bands that come from Florida,
people that
get out of Florida, they're just bands with chemistry. Marilyn Manson, Matchbox 20, 7 Mary 3. Mm-hmm. It's just bands that came from nowhere that were serious. There's no scene. There's no music. I mean, there's a lot of bands, but like punk rock and ska music is like huge. And Tampa, Florida is the home of death metal.
Mm. All right.
So it's like it was death metal. And the first thing, we're the first thing to come out of Jacksonville, Florida since like Lynyrd Skynyrd and 38 Special. You know, like there used to be a scene. And now there's actually, since Limp Bizkit, Matchbox 20, Marilyn Manson, Filter, coming from Florida, there's a scene that's starting to build.
There's a lot of talented people there, a lot of good musicians.
There's nothing to do.
Everybody is just practicing.
I mean, really.
Yeah, but they don't know, you know what I mean?
Yeah. It's definitely a place to find new talent. I mean, everybody's in their garages and they're just serious. They're really serious. It's not like the glam scene, like in Los Angeles or something where there's a billion bands and half of them suck. Some of them are good, but they just don't even care. They're just happy to be in the scene and be wearing leather pants.
Yeah, because most of the people in Florida, like most of the music from Florida, is made by people who don't really like Florida. So, you know, because it's just we live in a total Navy town, you know, and there's nothing to do.
It's really beautiful women. It's really hot. Mm-hmm. I mean, really hot.
Japan must be quite tough for you guys. It's really freezing.
Right, it's not that cold. There's places in the United States that are freezing. You can't even walk outside.
We just finished touring all up north.
Ice on every road you walk on.
Yeah. You play a show and walk through a blizzard to get to the tour bus. Uh-huh. You know, and there's already 3 inches of snow on the ground. You're just going.
I'm sure.
Osaka, yeah, the girl great band called
Yellow Machine Gun.
Yeah. They were really cool. Yeah, you know, last night the guys were really cool, Bloody Imitation Society.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it wasn't so original or so groundbreaking. Tonight the band sounds like Korn.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly like Korn. That's playing Creepy Girl.
Okay.
Right, you know, there.
Right
there.
Right,
but you know, they're, it's good to know that there's musicians all over the world that are serious about their music.
And into
this style. I've been watching videos on that Live Y? In our hotel, they don't have MTV.
Oh.
No MTV in the hotel. Yeah. So, but the video, I hear cool music, really cool Japanese music.
Oh, yeah? You
yeah,
like
I
it?
Like, you know, a lot of the music. Uh-huh. I can't understand the words.
That man with the singer had pink hair and looked like a girl, kind of.
Yeah, I seen that.
What's the band? Right.
Shaznara.
Yeah.
Shaznara. Okay.
They are Let's crazy.
Anyways, okay, so I'm really glad that you like it here in Japan. I heard the crowd went really wild last night.
Last night was probably the best show of our career, last night.
Yeah. I wonder why they booked you in this place.
I don't think they really knew, because, I mean, you think about it, I mean, we're just starting out.
Right.
You know what I mean? So for them to see, like, sold out two nights in a row in Tokyo from a band they haven't even probably maybe even heard before.
Yeah,
it's gotta be saying something, you know what I mean? This is a fresh new scene.
The ticket prices here are outrageous. We want to come back with a full production and put the tickets to 1,500 or 3,000 at the most.
Okay.
You know, because there's no reason to pay 5,000 yen to see us, to see anybody. That's $50. Well, I wouldn't pay $50 to see anyone.
The people have to pay for your hotels and stays.
But you know, that's still, there's people out there that want to come to the show that maybe only like one song, that maybe if they saw the band they'd like it all, they can't. It's so much money.
It's true that the ticket price is making it hard for the kids to come to shows like this. So
yeah, when we come back, we're going to drop it in half.
All right.
Yeah. Yeah. We're totally surprised that, you know, the shows have, there have been as many people.
Okay.
You know, because we found out last night how much the tickets were.
So what does MTV think about on Bizkit?
Oh, we love it. We're wondering if you're not making a new video. We only have Counterfeit right now. Right?
We're going to make a video for Sour.
Okay. Okay, I think I gotta let you guys go right now. So
okay.
The people are resting with them.
Yeah.
ということで、Limp Bizkitのメンバーを迎えてお送りしました。